Let us define the asymptotic notation big omega to calculate the lower bound. Look at this particular graph. Along the x-axis we have plotted n. So, n has got plotted along the x-axis. Look at these two functions. One is f of n and the one is c into g of n. See, when the value of n is n0 or lesser than that, when the value is n is lesser than n0, then c into gn and f into n, f of n, you see, they can be greater than or less than or equal to, anything was happening there. But when the value of n is greater than equal to n0, from that very particular point, you are finding that c into g of n is always denoting the lower bound of f of n. So, this is denoting the lower bound. That means f of n cannot go below this c into gn. So, big omega gn is equal to f of n, there exist positive constant c and n0 such that 0 is less than equal to c into g of n. So, 0 is less than equal to, so that means c into g of n will be positive or 0, which is less than equal to f of n, because f of n will having the lower bound, that is c into g of n, for all n greater than equal to n0, for all n greater than equal to n0. Big omega notation gives a lower bound for a function to within a constant factor. We write f of n is equal to big omega of gn if there are positive constants n0 and c such that to the right of n0, the value of f of n, to the right of n0 means this side, the value of f of n always lies on or above c into g of n. So, that has been written in text. Okay, now let us solve one problem on this. So, let us consider one example. Example, prove that 5n square plus 3n plus 1 is equal to big omega of n square. So, here I am considering this one as f of n. I am writing this one as this. So, obviously, this f of n is greater than 5 into n square when n is greater than 1. When the n is greater than 1, I can write this. So, now what will happen? What will happen now, you see, I can also make it when n is greater than equal to 1. So, there also it will work. So, now you see this f of n, here f of n is greater than 5 into g of n. So, I am considering n square as g of n. So, from the definition, we are having the definition like this. So, 0 less than equal to c into g of n is less than equal to f of n for all n greater than equal to n0. So, here you see n0 is equal to 1, here c is equal to 5 as I am doing, and g of n is equal to n square. So, we can easily write, because it was told that big omega of gn is equal to f of n. So, that is why I can write that this f of n is equal to big omega of n square. And so, here I have done this, that is n0 is equal to 1, c is equal to 5, and g of n is equal to n square. So, in this way, hence I can write f of n is equal to big omega of n square, and that was asked to be proved and it has been proved, so hence proved. So, in this way we can prove this particular example. So, now we are remaining with the last asymptotic notation, we are going to discuss that one. Please watch the next video and that will be in the continuation of this one, and thanks for watching this one.